Hello, this is how I made my 2x2 pineapple Rubik's cube. What I'm going to do is take a regular pineapple, cut it into eighths and fit it over this 2x2. This is the same one I used to make the pork pie cube. So it has the nails sticking out, so that will make sure the pieces sort of stay on. Because it's fruit, it's still going to be quite soft. So like the pork pie, I'm going to freeze it at certain stages to kind of keep it into place. Now, it would be great if I could have this bit included, but I think it's going to be too difficult. There's no way I can cut it through that way and then through that way. It's just going to fall apart. There is a possibility of having the 2x2 kind of in it like that, so the top bit stays as one and it's just on a corner. But to accurately cut those planes, like it's going to be sort of that way and that way and that way, it's going to be incredibly difficult to get that accurate. I am going to get rid of this first. Obviously I could just cut straight through it, but I want to make sure I get the lines exactly right. I mean, it's still going to be inaccurate, but I've got to kind of make it the least inaccurate as possible, or the most accurate possible, I suppose is a better way of saying it. Right, it doesn't look too bad. So now I'm going to start cutting out like little cubes from each one, so then it can fit in. Okay, so I've cut out all the pieces of pineapple that I need to. I've put elastic bands around them to sort of hold them together to sort of see how it looks. And I think it looks pretty good to me. So before I actually use this one, I'm going to test it with this without the nails. I can just sort of see if there's any more to cut out. And as it's fruit, I can kind of push it in a bit to sort of seal up the gaps. And because I've been able to put an elastic band around it, then I can put it in one go, whereas with the pork pie that wasn't really possible, so I had to sort of put each one on one at a time, so that's why it really did look pretty terrible. But this one should be much easier. I'm going to stick it in a freezer and come back to it later. Actually, I've got some of these pieces of thin metal, so I'm going to put a few of those in, just kind of so it stops it freezing to itself. I mean, they're probably not needed, but it doesn't do any harm. Frozen to the core is a very apt expression for this puzzle right now, and it would take a few minutes to work it in. Then there will be a relatively short period of time where it is thawed enough to use, but still frozen enough to stay together. This is a key to using soft food in puzzle making. The pineapple is now at its peak usability, so let's scramble it for a real test. Unfortunately, it has popped, and being a 2x2, it's very hard to just push a piece back in again. I later discovered inaccuracies were causing misalignments. So I started the whole process again with another pineapple and created the one you saw in a demo video. For those who didn't see it, I will repeat the solved part of it here. Once you have worked out a solution, 2x2 cubes can be solved very quickly since there's not many permutations. This though is a bit harder because the pineapple chunks are very similar looking. Orientation is obvious, but not where they go. I'm starting with four chunks at one end, which is the equivalent to a side of a regular 2x2. I have two chunks in place, and I am now adding the third. The third is now in place, so one more to go. It's on the bottom, so slightly trickier than usual. Okay, so that's one end done. I will now orientate the other end chunks. This is where my solution can be really bad. Instead of working out a method for this exact situation, I will do the same move twice. That move leaves one chunk alone and orientates the other three clockwise. All the time I am doing this, I can feel that it wants to fall apart. Hopefully though, it will stay together just long enough for me to complete the solve. It looks like I've been lucky here and the chunks are also in their correct positions. This happens 1 in 12 times. When I was inventing my Rubik's Cube solution back in 1980, there was a day or so when I could solve it, but only if I got lucky with the corner positions. So I would do it over and over again until they came correct. Shortly afterwards, I worked out a corner moving algorithm to complete my method. In a future video, I will show how I made this fruity puzzle, so stay tuned.